Russia's severe crackdown on dissent has likely quashed many such protests within the country. In fact, large faithful crowds attended today's Victory Day events in Moscow. They listened on as Vladimir Putin repeated baseless accusations to sell his war. Some world leaders thought the Russian president might use this moment to declare triumph in Ukraine. He, of course, did not. The U.S. ambassador to the U.N. told CNN exclusively that's because he can't legitimately claim a win.
President Putin has recognized he has no victory to celebrate. His efforts in Ukraine have not succeeded. He was not able to go into Ukraine and bring them to their knees in a few days and have them surrender. He gave up on taking Kyiv, and he has moved to reassess his positioning in Ukraine. So there was no victory to celebrate. There was no reason for him to either declare victory or declare a war that he has already been carrying on for more than 2 months.
So President Putin can't claim victory, so what exactly is his next move? Someone who might have insight on that is Mikhail Kasyanov. He's a Russian politician who was once Mr. Putin's prime minister. Now, though, he supports Ukraine. Mr. Kasyanov joins us live now from an undisclosed location in Eastern Europe. Mikhail, thank you so much for being with us. So we just heard there several reasons why Vladimir Putin was unable to declare victory during this Victory Day parade. However, a lot of people thought that he would use this opportunity, this speech, to perhaps declare war on Ukraine as opposed to it being a special military operation. Clearly, he decided against that. Why do you think that is?
Yes, and it was not possible for Mr. Putin to declare a war and to call for mobilization. To call for mobilization, you need to declare war in accordance with Russian Constitution. To declare the war, you need to have invasion. There were some shootings on the border with Russia, but Russian propaganda, Putin's propaganda, didn't use it for that. To recognize the war and to declare the war and call for mobilization, it means recognize just weakness. It means just, as he called it, special operation was not successful. And in fact, it is not successful. And that's why just it was not possible for Mr. Putin to recognize unsuccess. It means he will continue to fight in the same manner. He is very nervous. His speech today was absolutely useless, without any enthusiasm, and a demonstration of appeared weakness.
All right, so by declaring war against Ukraine, in a sense, he would be admitting that what he has done in Ukraine so far, the special operation, has basically failed. And he doesn't want to do that. So then what is his strategy moving forward? How does he win this?
Yeah, he's, as I said, he's nervous. He didn't expect just that such a tough sanctions would be imposed. It really tough touched Russian economy, financial system.
He must have expected that tough sanctions would be imposed. He must have known that was coming.
No, he thought that the level of sanctions would be like it was in 2014 after annexation of Crimea, which he easily overcame. But this time, the sanctions were really devastating for Russian economy. And he understands that now, just the whole operation, the whole war with Ukraine, turns to, I would say, competition or war of economic potentials, economic and military potentials. And the Ukraine, with the, military supplies from the United States and other countries, just could get a decisive advantage in the battlefield. That's what Mr. Putin is afraid. That's why he needs just to go further on the coming couple of weeks.
So there was clearly a massive miscalculation. And even though Western leaders had warned, even before the invasion, that there were going to be harsh sanctions, he didn't anticipate that they were going to be this bad. And on top of that, there's now discussion of an oil embargo. Of course, that is how Russia has been paying for this war. So if, you know, the West clamps down on energy exports from Russia, if Vladimir Putin's methods of paying for this war is threatened in that way, plus you've got all the Russian casualties, what happens next? What is his strategy going forward?
Yeah, I think that just his strategy would be definitely to keep this corridor he already managed to create between Crimea land corridor, between Crimea and Donbas. He tries to expand the occupied territory of Donbas, not quite successful as so far, but the land corridor already exists and he cannot move furthermore. And as I said, today's speech was recognition of unsuccess of the operation, although he called for future victory, but there was no victory as of today.
So Western leaders are, of course, going to be combing through the speech, analyzing every single word. What do you think the main takeaway should be for Europe, the United States, of course, NATO as a whole?
I think just G7 recently made a very, very important statement a couple of days ago. The statement was devoted exactly for this issue. And they jointly said just we need to see Mr. Putin as defeated. That is the beginning. If it happens, that will be the beginning of the end of Putin's era. It would last for a few months, maybe 1 year, but definitely just combination of these factors, the huge support of Ukraine, moral and military supplies, and simultaneously just create a weakness of Putin's ability to fund this war. That would create a situation when Mr. Putin would look as defeated. It means just internal turmoil, internal protests will grow up in Russia, and that will be, as I said, the change. The regime changed by the hands of Russians.
I mean, it's just so hard to tell, especially, you know, being outside of Russia, just how strong the genuine support is for Vladimir Putin. Obviously, there are people who genuinely support him. There are people who pretend to support him. There are people who secretly do not support him. But how do you think ordinary Russian people, ordinary civilians, would interpret the speech he made today?
I would say the society is split by 50-50 these days. And in fact, this half of population, which were foolished by very sophisticated propaganda, and they're listening to this propaganda, and they believe to Mr. Putin, and they support him, for them, they would applaud this speech, and they will continue to believe that the victory would be achieved very soon. But other 50% of population who don't support this war and this criminal activity of Mr. Putin's regime, of course, they keeping silence and waiting just when the situation will start changing. And by little efforts, they cannot afford just great efforts and to have a protest on the streets, because last year Mr. Putin spent all the time to create a fear among people and put lots of people in jail to demonstrate how harsh that his reaction would be if any demonstration appears. And today these people just waiting for some kind of weakness. Today's speech for them, it's a signal that Mr. Putin has started weakening.
All right, Mikhail, thank you so much for being with us and sharing your perspective, because, of course, you know Vladimir Putin personally. So that is a valuable insight that you've offered. Thank you.